Thanks for the warm welcome. Thanks for the time. Thanks for the invitation to be here to share some thoughts on plastics, plasticity, the circular economy. I indeed lead this circular economy practice, but we're going to focus really deeply into plastics, on plastics right now today. And the situation, as you see, I think is not good. The situation is not really improving either. And society demands from us, as I think a business community and students as well, I heard that we act much, much faster. Because conferences like these, how enjoyable they are, took place last year, and the year before, and will happen next year as well. So we need to act much faster. Actually, with a client of mine, of ours, I believe I found one single piece of the puzzle to act a bit faster. So I'm going to show you what I think it is. We call it the plastics dashboard. And implementing a company-specific plastics dashboard, I think, provides management as well as the marketeers somewhere in the outskirts of the company to really become action-oriented in realizing plastics strategies. I'll come to that in a second. So first of all, indeed, my name, Jan-Willem van der Beukel. I work at PwC. It's a global consultancy firm. Multi-competence, and I lead our work on circular economy based in Amsterdam, doing work across the globe. And what I do is crafting circular strategies together with customers and also supporting them in execution, roadmaps, that sort of stuff. Now, my clients are in the consumer goods sector as well as in, for example, the chemical sector, big corporates, small startups. We work with the Plastic Soup Foundation, with Plastic Whale, with Ionica, but also, for example, in India, very interestingly, for the World Bank. Trying to fix the plastic problem of India and get all that stuff as feedstock to the textiles industry in Bangladesh. So interesting stuff. A year ago or so, the issue that I feel the business community was concerned with and they were faced with was circular is such a big topic. How do I make this actionable? How do I make this small? What's my first step? If I'm a big company, I can't look into and bio-based and sharing and refurbishing and recycling. It's just too much. So the question was, what should I do as a meaningful first step? What does circular packaging look like, actually? There's no common framework. Or where does it sit in the company? Is this something for innovation, for strategy, for sustainability? How does this work? It's just too new. They also asked, where's the pot of gold? So where, in the reports you read, there's a lot of money to be earned with circular economy. Now, where is it? Where's my business case? That sort of questions, around a year ago, I'd say. Now, how we typically approach that is with practical strategists that we are, a multi-competence team, because strategy is nice and they look good on PowerPoint, but in the end, if you are a sustainability guy or lady, or you sit in strategy and you're responsible for that piece of the ambition of your company, all of a sudden, after it's been agreed upon, your legal colleagues will ask nasty questions. Your supply chain colleagues will say, not in my KPI set. Yeah, so what we think is our USP is that we get those people on board right from the start, so that those strategies actually work in practice and not just in PowerPoint. Now, all this is necessary to create strategies. But then we still have this situation. Strategies are nice, but then operationalizing them is key. And not that easy. If this is a typical company, FMCG, producing, I don't know what, those bottles on your table, for example, I mean, these are just some of the internal stakeholders that need to act differently, probably, to deliver a plastics strategy. Just some of the stakeholders. And then there's even a second ring, because these are also stakeholders. Yeah, Maarten Biermans is giving you this loan. He wants to see data, he wants to see impact reporting. NGO at your door, they want to talk to you about this as well. So there's a wealth, plethora of stakeholders, all needed and all having information needs on plastics, on your current performance. These companies that have good strategies, they do nice things. They produce socks of plastic ocean plastic like these. Not very pretty, but well, it's something. It helps solve a little bit of the issue. But since there are so many people involved, what you typically see is that this responsibility sits with an LCA person somewhere in a company. Difficult words, difficult metrics, difficult data, and a category manager, good marketeer, says, yeah, well, can you help me? I need to make a decision. I'm going to put this bottle on the market in India in a month's time or so. What should I do? Yeah, well, it's very difficult. Do you have time? No, I don't have time. Okay. So what you typically see is that there's a lack of actionable data within companies like these. And the cliche is true. What gets measured gets managed. So you need to get the right data for the right people to be able to act. Now imagine that you have in a company not just a strategy, but for these people who all, as I said, have a stake and have a responsibility to deliver on the strategy. Imagine all those people are served. Imagine that you are in management of this company and that you get a question from an investor or a financier. And you can actually have the actual data and not just a one-off annual report, which is outdated the day it's printed. That you have the actual data to have that discussion with your investor with an up-to-date picture on your plastics performance as well as your progress against your target. Now imagine that you're the category manager, marketeer, hip, happening with this bottle, and you actually have the actionable insight to help you make the trade-off between margin, between the cost, between the possibility of going bio-based, or recycled plastic, or lightweighting. Many opportunities. Imagine that there's a tool that helps you make those trade-offs, make those decisions. And imagine you're in legal in this company, and you know there's a lot of regulation coming up in India, in Europe. Every day there's a new EPR guideline somewhere in the world. Imagine that you, as a legal person, will also know, hey, this is going to be the impact of that new piece of regulation. Now, that is what actually is possible. This is just one interface that we developed. The interface for management. Because everyone has different information needs, but in the end, it all comes down to a backbone of good, incredible data with the right interface for the right stakeholder. Now, this is for the management of the Netherlands. I've anonymized it. If you're in management, of course, you're interested in the environmental stuff, but also in the financial stuff. If you look at the left, if this is, for example, if your interest at a certain point in time is the Dutch market. And for the Dutch market, you probably want to know, how much plastics do I put on the market? How much of it is already hitting my recyclable, compostable, reusability targets? How much of it is already post-consumer recycled? Those sort of questions answered at a glance, up to date. And you also want to know, because these are also often overlooked, the numbers on actually the cost of it all. And not just the cost of procuring plastics, but also the cost of all these taxes and the levies and the EPR stuff you need to pay. And you also have the insight on what does it mean for brand A? What does it mean for brand B? How do they compare? If those data are available for you as management to have your conversation with those brand managers, with those category managers, man, that drives execution. So it's as simple as that, I think. That's one piece of the puzzle, to have a plastics dashboard in a company, if you're an FMCG or you're somewhere in this space. Obviously, drill downs are available, different interfaces are available and need to be created. But I truly believe, and that's my call today, it's time for all those good strategies and these big ambitions that I see on paper, that there are time to get them executed, so that the macro figures will also show that we're actually active as a business community. I think we need to empower all internal stakeholders, wherever they sit in our company, to make informed decisions. So my call is implement some sort of a plastics dashboard. I'm very much looking forward to hearing your feedback and continuing this conversation after today. Thank you very much.